vote against renewing the export-import ban. And he had a very principled reason. He said, I'm not going to do it because Boeing gets 40% of the money. And we shouldn't be spending that kind of money on corporate welfare. Now, here's the problem. They get 40% of the money because the most expensive thing we export is big jets. And because their only competition is Airbus, a European company. Near as I can tell, it's the only place where he disagrees with European social policy and economic policy. Airbus is far more heavily subsidized by the Europeans than Boeing. But if we don't help them lower the cost of financing the exports, Airbus gets more jobs, Boeing gets less. Hillary doesn't see Boeing. She sees tens of thousands of good union jobs paying high wages with good health care benefits and good retirement, and she thinks we should be the job. The flip side of the 40% is 60% of the money goes to thousands and thousands of small American companies, some of them literally very small businesses, who somehow have found a way to sell their products around the world. And she thinks we ought to help them. So you just have to decide. You have to decide whether you want progress or protest. You have to decide what you are willing to do to make other people's lives better. Now, I think Hillary ought to be president, not because she's the best qualified, although she is, not because it'd be great to have the first president who's a woman, although I think it would. I think you ought to vote for her, and everybody ought to vote for her, because she's the single best change maker I have ever known. And because in a deeply divided country, and a divided Congress, ever since she went to Washington, everything she accomplished, she has the Republican support for. When she did a children's health insurance program, when we lost the health care bill, she had Republican support. There are 8 million kids insured right now. When she wanted to do something about adopted kids or foster kids who were trapped in foster care and aging out, going out in the world at 18, no education, no training, nowhere to live. So she went to a Republican who disliked me more than anybody in Congress. The House Leader, Tom Lane, she said, I know you're an adopted parent. You've got to help me with this. Because people are scared to adopt kids who aren't infants. They're scared to adopt kids with disabilities and special needs. We need to write a bill to give people a big tax credit to do that. They wrote the bill, all I had to do was sign it. And by the time I left office, we had an 80% increase in the number of kids adopted out of foster care. When she was a senator, she worked with John McCain and Lindsey Graham to get young Americans returning from Iraq and Afghanistan same health care that regular veterans got if they were in the Guard and Reserve. Take care of everybody with traumatic brain injury better. To take better care of people with post-traumatic stress syndrome. She worked with Republicans all over New York to revive the rural economy. You may find this hard to believe, but a lot of New York is extremely rural, heavily Republican, and heavily agricultural. When she ran for re-election, the head of the Farm Bureau on Long Island endorsed her. And the press said, are you sure you're doing this? Aren't you a big Republican? He said, yeah, I'm a Republican. Well, why are you endorsing her? He said, because all these politicians sound real good during an election. All I know is she is the only person in either party who has ever actually done anything to help the family farmers.